Batya Gotsveld established the American Mizrahi Women's Organization. She was born in 1888 in a small town in Poland. Her family immigrated to the U.S., where she grew up and married. Leaders of the religious Zionist Mizrahi organization often met in Batya's parents' home. Batya listened to the men talk about establishing a Jewish homeland in the land of Israel and asked other women to join her in helping realize the Zionist dream. In 1925, Batya Gotsveld established the Mizrahi Women's Organization that later became Amit. The initial need that Batya recognized was for higher-level education for religious girls. In 1930, she and her husband made Aliyah and settled in Tel Aviv. In 1933, Beit Sirot Mizrahi, the first professional school for girls in Israel, opened in Jerusalem. This was the beginning of the Amit network. Batya remained personally involved in planning, executing, and fundraising. Amit Kfar Batya Youth Village is named for Batya, who died in 1962. She did not have any biological children. All of the Amit children were her children. Today, Amit educates more than 30,000 girls and boys in over 110 schools all over Israel. Volunteers all over the world have contributed to make Amit what it is today. You can be a link in that grand chain of generations in Amit. Now that we know where we've been, let's take a look at where we're going next.
The changes for teaching and learning are going to be huge over the next decade or so, because children are going to have access to learning from many more sources. But we shouldn't lose track of the idea that teachers can still have a major impact on the learning of children and on their lives.
First, we have to trust the teacher to give them opportunity to have initiative in class. If we would like that our children will be creative, we need to give them opportunity and to the environment to do a lot of activity in school. Today they are very passive. They have lecture and they don't have any activity in schools. So we need to teach the teachers how to do project, how to do teamwork in school, and to be available to all the skills that we need for the children in the 21st century. I can tell you that it's a culture change. It's not simple at all. In the beginning, we analyze with them the need. We ask questions. We are relevant to our kids. We know how to prepare them to the future. And when they start to understand the need of change, they start with a small group. We are taking R&D team in schools. They are coming day a week to learn. Teachers come not to teach, come to learn once a week how to change their schools. We give them the responsibility to lead this change, so then they are taking the other teachers in school and they make them a teamwork to change all the schools.